Hi, this is Iva Keene. I'm a naturopath specializing in fertility and co-founder of naturalfertilityprescription.com, a site dedicated to providing you with alternative fertility solutions where you will find a wealth of information on how you can restore your fertility naturally. Today, I would like to talk to you about high FSH levels and the recent findings which are suggesting that your blood type could be affecting your ovarian reserve and the levels of follicle stimulating hormone. A recent study in the US where 560 women participated in found that women who had O blood types had higher FSH levels, and their FSH levels were up to level 10, which is indicative of low or fair ovarian reserve. And so the scientists are suggesting that general populations should be studied as well, because these women were all seeking fertility treatment and to be able to conclusively say whether or not your blood type has something to do with your ovarian reserve, and if yes, to what extent it affects your ovarian reserve and your follicle stimulating hormone levels. The study also found that the blood type A's don't have this problem because their cells carry an A antigen, which seems to protect them from this effect. And so this is quite interesting, because majority of world's population are blood type O's, about 46%, followed by blood type A's of 38%. So that is a pretty large group of women that would have this problem. So it will be interesting to see what further studies show. So let's have a look at some of the causes of high FSH, regardless of blood type. We see high FSH levels in women who have lower or low estrogen levels, also women who are just starting their menopause and who are menopausal. We also see women with high FSH levels who have extremely high estrogen levels, and also where the ovary responds poorly to FSH stimulation, so the ovary could be resistant to FSH. And another factor which is also very common is stress. Extreme levels of stress or very high levels of stress can also cause it. And it's interesting to note here that the quality of your eggs is impacted by what goes on for 90 days before ovulation, and this is where your primordial follicles are woken up and start to mature so that they can be ready and fully mature for ovulation. And this process takes anywhere between 90 to 120 days, which is why it's crucial that during that time you really take care of yourself, that you eat an optimal diet with optimal protein and complex carbohydrates and good fats, so essential fatty acids. Also important to good egg quality are your iron levels and your vitamin E levels. A lot of women tend to be iron deficient and anemic, which can result with fatigue, with pallor in their face, heavy periods, and also with poor egg quality. There are also herbs that you can take which have been traditionally used to help women in their late 30s and early 40s produce good quality eggs and minimize the risk of miscarriage. And these herbs are shatavari, dong quai, and romania. So they're very good herbs you can also consider if your FSH levels are high and if you have poor ovarian reserve and poor egg quality. It's interesting to note that Dr. Adamo, who is the pioneer or the father of blood type diet suggests that all blood types should predominantly eat animal-based diets. So lots of meat, poultry, fish, not so much eggs and dairy, and they should really stay away from wheat. And what's interesting about these findings of his is that they contradict the findings from the nurse's health study done at Harvard, which suggested that women who eat predominantly plant-based diets have a better fertility levels and tend to suffer less from infertility caused by an ovulation, so they don't tend to get problems associated with ovulation. And so that's an interesting point to note. Also, another interesting thing that Dr. Dharma suggests is that iodine and kelp, which is a sea algae, very rich in iodine, magnesium, B group vitamins, which are all important for hormonal balance, but in particular for your thyroid gland, are very beneficial to blood type O's, and iodine acts as a tonic and has medicinal effects on blood type O's. And what's interesting to note here is that iodine is one of the key minerals involved in thyroxine production and is essential to healthy thyroid function. And your ovaries also have thyroxine receptors, and they need thyroxine in order to activate follicle production and hormone production. So if your thyroid function is suboptimal, then your ovarian function will be suboptimal as well. And it could be that this link between the thyroid and the blood type O's has something to do with the ovarian function and follicle stimulating hormone levels being high. But this is still early days, and we have to wait for more studies and for further findings. I would love to hear your thoughts. Please share with us, what blood type are you, and leave us a comment. Thanks for listening. Bye-bye.